has multiple T-33s, and the reason why he came up with Acemaker, and you saw his helmet there in that video, the way it's painted, is so that multiple pilots could fly this profile. He also does military training. As you mentioned, it is a training aircraft, and that aircraft is still used by our armed forces for various training exercises. So Greg does a lot of jobs, is a very, very competent pilot, and obviously an astute businessman, as he has created this with the T-33, both an air show act and also something that is helping our servicemen and women perform their jobs at an even higher level. I'm keeping my eyes on him. He is behind the crowd right now. Our cameras would have you believe he's right here in front of us, but he is quite a distance away. Great camera work going on as he prepares to circle around, and there's lots of fun stuff in store for his routine today as he comes around wide behind the crowd and makes his way coming toward show center. We're hearing now from the announcer stand that Airbus has cleared him into the aerobatic box. An aerobatic box is a, think of it as an invisible sterile fish tank that exists in the sky, and nothing can fly in there unless Airbus says it can, and it is designed for pilot safety primarily.
So we've gone from a silent act to something that's going to be just a little bit louder. And here he comes now on the right side of our experience here, coming in hot, hot in the T-33.
Woo!
Woo! Got a little bit of pyro, a little strafing action there. I could feel that in my chest.
Our director, Craig, just off screen having a laugh. It doesn't get old, folks, and if it does, maybe this isn't the right thing for you, because I love seeing it. We're not done with that. We are not done with that. He was mentioning when we talked to him, we did an interview with him, that this particular T-33, I'm reading here on the screen, does it sound right that he said that one in particular was Russian but acquired in Canada? Does that ring a bell?
Yes, so they were built in Canada as well as the United States, and this one is actually the Canadian vintage.
That's okay. Thanks for the reminder.
And look at just how effortlessly it comes up and over the top there.
He flew a friend's in 2007 and decided to get one. I love that. That maybe happens with a friend's car, but certainly not with a jet, a jet trainer. You know what? I think I want one of those.
Well,
that was a fun flight.
I did this air show with you, and I decided to get a mini jet. We've established already. So
two of them, of which neither one of us are qualified to fly it. We don't have the financing.
We'll work it out.
we'll figure it out.
I want to talk, since we're talking about jets, compared to the compared to the F-35, it's very small. We saw the F-35 earlier. This is an aircraft that's 37 feet 9 inches long, 38 feet in the wingspan, and about 11 feet, almost 12 feet off the ground. And to put it in terms of weights, right, gross weight, max takeoff weight, let's do that one, 15,000 pounds. Very different from the Interstate Cadet we just saw.
We had a question coming into our technical truck. Phil Watson, if you're out there, you're wondering what the oldest jet was that we had out there, and it is, in fact, this one. So, Phil, to answer your question, it's what you're watching right now on the screen. Thank you for your question.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, and like we said, it's a pilot maker. It's another pilot maker. It's the first operational jet fighter and trainer for the United States. And you can see here, we've got the little factoid on the screen. When he's not flying this, Greg's flying business jets. So that one caught me by surprise.
Me too. I love it.
And if you were to make those sorts of booms with the T-33 in real life, not just with pyro on the field, it had two hard points. So 2,000 pounds of bombs or rockets on that thing if you wanted to do that in a non-air show setting. Whoa!
Yeah, they've really done this well. It's an interesting airplane, and obviously one now that Greg, I believe, has three of them. It's certainly an airframe that he is passionate about,
yeah.
As a force multiplier, if you will, now that he's purchased multiple of them.
He's creatively named them Acemaker, Acemaker 2, and Acemaker 3. And there we are on board with him, Steph. Look at that.
What a great, okay, here he comes. This is fantastic. Woo, You see it there off to the right.
Oh, that was awesome. Oh, that was so cool.
That right there is the vantage, seeing what he sees in the cockpit. What a treat.
Maximum speed of this aircraft, 600 miles an hour, cruises around 455 miles an hour. He's repositioning for another go at the field.
Oh, you can still see the smoke.
Nice, graceful roll over the top there, past the smoke. And looking at his air show routine, Steph, what's really interesting to see is a lot of the maneuvers, split S, loop, Cuban 8, slow roll. We were talking about arresti before, or like aerobatic competition. These are a lot of moves that if you get involved in aerobatics, you're going to do, maybe not in a shooting star.
Yeah.
But you're going to do. So it's kind of a cool thing to see. And here he's coming right at us right now.
I saw it compound. I saw it on the monitor. Thanks, Greg. It's cool to see us for a minute there, my friend.
Well, as I was looking behind us, Steph, what's really interesting to see is we keep talking about the topography of the airport. We're up on a little bit of a plateau above the main airport here. And so he was able actually to get below us just before he pulled up there. And here he is again rolling in.
He's definitely designed a routine that keeps him in front of the crowd. He's not gone for very long when he's repositioning. And it is smoke on the whole time.
While he's coming around here, I'll mention that the power plant Allison J33A35 centrifugal flow turbojet engine.
That's a mouthful.
It is. And it gets a little extra thrust on takeoff with some water injection, but up to 5,400 pound feet of thrust. That's a lot of thrusts. Again now. Sorry, I was distracted. We had some buses.
The Blue Angels friends and family have arrived, and we are right next door to them. Actually, friends of mine here. You know, we do a lot of air shows across the country. You get to know folks, and we were just helpfully suggesting they drive a little bit farther down the line.
Yeah. So
as I mentioned, we're at Show Center. This is where all the action is, so we're doing a little crowd control while we're out here. But that's fine. You want to see Greg Colyer flying anyway, so we'll keep him on the screen while we move some folks around.
Move some buses around. Greg Colyer, by the way, proficient in solo aerobatics. Obviously, we're seeing that here. Dog fighting, great for the T-33.
Night and some shows. Of his military work.
Absolutely. And then the formation aerobatics. He's got a lead formation card. You can see him now. He's got the aircraft in a dirty configuration. What we mean when we say that is that all the stuff is out, right? So you've got the landing gear down now, more of a landing configuration. You see the flaps extending. The flaps are those inboard controls, control surfaces. They increase drag and lift on the aircraft.
So right now it's a very different airplane than the one that he's been flying.
Absolutely.
The control surfaces don't work quite like they did. The aircraft is flying at a slower speed. Oh, goodness sakes.
Hello,
we're
everybody.
Live on the air, but I'm giving hugs to my Blue Angels friends who have to come through our set to actually get to where they need to go. I don't know if we could do a picture-in-picture of this. We've got our friends joining us now from the Blues in their cowboy hats, getting into the Montana spirit. Our floor director, Brian's come out.
He's like, okay, hello, everybody.
It's a good day. We are good to go.
Ha ha ha! Greg, meanwhile, has cleaned up the aircraft again, gears up, flaps are up. You think about the speed differential, right, of an aircraft that can go that fast, up to 600 miles an hour. You don't want landing gear hanging out in the wind for that.
You know, sometimes you see the F-18s do the dirty roll on takeoff, where they'll actually take off with their landing gear out and do a complete roll. And you'll actually notice with the sink, right, how much altitude they lose in that dirty configuration before they tuck everything up and get out of there.
And that's just a testament, when we see the F-18 later, that's just a testament to the amount of power it has to be able to overcome all of that. And I love seeing the heat, just the heat. Here he comes now again, making another pass. This aircraft's got a range of 1,275 miles. And if you want to get aggressive with it, you can get up to 48,000 feet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it can get up there at 4,870 feet per minute. That's a lot of feet per minute. Feets per minute.
I do love it. Thrusts. Feets. Greg is a great champion of expanding the air show message for folks, always giving media rides, introducing people to the airframe and his passion for what he does in the sky, and hopefully inspiring folks and or just helping improve the air show coverage. Billings, Montana, the folks on the radio and the television stations, our partner Q2, and certainly what I've seen in print, this is a community that supports our military and
sure.
supports this air show, and it's really been a treat to see. It's been a lot of fun.